गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी लेसन 6 डिसीजन कंट्रोल स्ट्रक्चर। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी इफ कंट्रोल स्ट्रक्चर, स्विच स्टेटमेंट, लूपिंग कंट्रोल स्ट्रक्चर, फॉर लूप, व्हाइल लूप, डू व्हाइल लूप। सो अबाउट दिस थिंग्स वी विल डिस्कस इन दिस चैप्टर। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग दिस डिसीजन कंट्रोल स्ट्रक्चर, बिकॉज समटाइम्स सपोज एनी स्टेटमेंट और एनी लाइक एनी कमांड विच यू वॉन्ट टू डू मीन्स फॉर रिपीटेडली यू वॉन्ट टू यूज इट। सो इन दैट केस वी विल यूज दिस इफ स्टेटमेंट लाइक स्विचिंग लाइक लूप स्टेटमेंट व्हाइल लूप्स दिस थिंग्स वी विल यूज। सो इन दैट केस while executing the programs sometimes it became necessary to change the order of execution of some statements or to repeat particular set of statement subject to a given condition. Okay, so this kind of condition required some logical decisions. So like which we want to do repeatedly again and again, like if a ticket is like some conditions if we are giving, like condition is like that if ticket are available then what we will do, we will watch the movie. If ticket is not available then what you have to do, have food in a restaurant. So like decision is there, means we have to take like decision, means if it is not possible then this will do, if it is not happen then another thing will do. If like same thing we have to like do doing like calculate all the numbers between 1 to 50, means add the sum add all the numbers between 1 to 50. So repeatedly we are doing 1 plus 2 plus 3. So like some repeated work is there. So in that case we will use this control structures. So first of all, computer also decides about the action depending on the condition being true or false. If it is a true or false, basically as we know that computer understand the binary language only, which is 0 and 1. 0 is for off and 1 is for on, or like true or false. Means suppose if it is a true then it will do, like here if ticket is available means it is like true, so then we will do this one. If it is a false means ticket is not available, then this work will be done. Or sometimes like Java condition control structures are categorized, so it is categorized in some parts you can see, which is like these are the kinds: selection control structure, first of all selection control structure, second looping control structure, third one jumping control structure. So about these three we will study here. So one by one we will discuss. So first of all, the selection statement cause the program control to be transferred to a specific location depending on outcome of condition expression. Okay, so it will be transferred to a specific location, means from here to here, so that will come under the selection statement. Means if it is not true so then here come, if it is available then come to here. So likewise it will be there, means it will be it will transfer to a specific location depending on the outcome of condition expression. Okay, if condition evaluate a true, a set of statement in a block is executed, otherwise different course of action. Means as I told that if it is a true it will come here, if it is a false come to here. So likewise it will be there. Okay, so Java supports two types of selection statement, which is if and switch. Okay, so it Java supports two types of selection statement. How many types of selection statement Java supports? Two only, if and switch. These two names are there, if and switch, these two selections which is provided by, which supports Java. First of all we will see, so now here we will discuss first of all if control structure. Okay, so what is the if? As you know that generally if, why we are using, like in if this one is correct, if it is wrong then do this one, if it is good then select this one. So we are having, if means we are just having, we are giving some condition, or like it is true then do this one. So simple, when we are using the if, you means when you are this if word is coming to your mind, what the its result, its outcome means result, how you will decide its result generally coming true or false, either like ha ya na. Okay, in this way this is coming. Okay, if it is true then it will do, if no then this one. Okay, so this is your if control structure. The statement containing if is referred two as bidirectional. It is a bidirectional, means it has the two direction, bidirectional branching, because it execute the block of statement depending on the conditional expression. Okay, the conditional expression consists of relation and logical operators and must evaluate to either true or false. So if there is a logical, means there will be used some logical operators. Already you have studied in your previous chapter 5, in when we are studying Java. So there are some operators, the relation operators are there. So there are logical operators also. So there is a logical operator, it is a true or false. Generally in the logical operators it gives true and false. Okay, if you have forgot it, you can just go and revise this one. At this logical, what is the logical operator, relation operators in your previous chapter. So in generally in the logical operator it gives the answer in true or false. It can be used many way in the program. So it can be, you how it can, this if, by the help of this if control, how it can be used. So it can be used in this if statement, if else statement, if else ladder. So there are three ways again to use this if statement. Okay, so first we will see this if statement, how to use this simple if statement. Okay, so actually we have to study here if and switch both, but here we have started with the if, and if have the three parts: if statement, if else statement, and if else if ladder. So one by one we will see. So first of all, if statement. So in the if statement, if statement is used to execute a program or block of statement if condition is true, otherwise it ignore. So only if you will use, only if. Okay, so it means if it will be true, so that will be executed, otherwise it will be ignored. Got it? So the condition, it means the condition is false, then the execution of statement in the body of if skip from the execution. Okay, in general syntax, so here is the syntax, how this if statement is working. Here is a boolean expression, here will be the some condition, like in this is the syntax of the if boolean expression, means like a greater than 0, a less than 0, likewise some expression will be here. So if it is a true, so then it will be executed, means under this, means this two braces, you can curly bracket, this block of statement here is that this block of statement gets executed if condition returns true. If this particular portion, if this portion will be true, if this will be true, then it will be executed, otherwise it will be terminated. So in this flowchart you can understand. So in this flowchart you can see this is start. So here is the text expression. Text means it will be checked that this a is greater than 0 or less than 0, whatever is that. If it is, it comes true, if it will comes true, means that will be satisfied, then it will go to the body of if. This is the body of if, this under this curly bracket, between these two curly bracket, whatever the program is written, so that will be executed. Okay, if it is false, then it will come out and it will be stopped. So now here you can see, like let's know some more facts is there. If statement allows a program to choose whatever or not to execute a particular statement. So does it mean? The if statement allows a program to choose whether or not to execute a particular program, means it will be execute or not. Simple. If it is okay, means it is a true, it will work, otherwise it will no. Okay, simple, true and false. So there are, based on these, some Java programs are there written. This program Java, write a program to check whether a number is greater than 4 using if statement. We have to, is given condition using the if statement. So we have to check this number is greater than 4. So first of all, public, as you know that this Java program, how to declare. So first of all we have to declare the class. So public if state, so we have given the name of the class if state. So under this if statement, again it is started with the curly bracket. So now here is, we have declared public static void main, we have generated one function. Okay, so here is that in this we have declared int a. okay, so this is, we have passed this variable through the this function, argument function, we have passed here int a, integer a. Already I told that you can declare it here, or here you can declare. So there are some methods how to do it. So in this in that chapter we have already I taught about in chapter 5. You can just check out that again. Okay. So here we have passed integer a, means integer a we have given. Now then after here is that again the again this curly bracket started. System dot print out means this will be displayed, it will give the print out entered number. So it will, because we know that under this to this double quoted, so whatever it will be written, that will be same, it will be displayed there. So enter the number, then after plus a, it means it, this is added, means after that whatever the value will be the a, that will come after that. This plus operator is tell that append it, means that will be concurrent, means that will be added, that will be joined with this. Okay, then after there is the condition is given, if a equals a greater than 4, there is again we have started, if a greater than 4 means the value, this a value, whatever the value we will enter, because when the program will run, computer will ask to you enter some number. So whatever the number you will enter, so that will be checked here. Now if a is greater than 4, if that number, whatever the number you have entered, and that number is greater than 4, if it is true, suppose you have entered 5, so that it means that will be the true. So then after it will come to here, and it will system again, it will print out the number is greater than 4. Okay, if suppose you have entered number, like you have entered 2, so that means your condition became false. So once your condition became false, it will not execute here, it will directly come to here. It will directly come to here when your is your false. When your condition is true, it will come to here. Okay, if it is a false, come directly, because in this if statement we know that how it does it work. If it is a true, then this under this, this is the block of statement that will be executed, condition is otherwise it will be terminated. You can understand from here also, if it is a true, then it will come here, otherwise it will come to the out of that curly braces. So if it is a false, then it will come to here and it will execute. Then one by one you can close the all this braces. Okay, this is the program, and you can check out this output is like this, enter number is 7. So first of all this will be displayed, enter number is 4, here is enter number is 7, because whenever it was asked you there may be entered 7. So this is the output of here. Then after, if it is a true, because it is greater than, so that's why it come to here. Suppose if you have entered number 1, suppose digit 1 you have entered, so in that case you will get here is enter number is 1, and this statement will be not there because it will not execute. So you will get this one, invalid number. So this you will get, the these two outputs you will get. Okay, now here is some facts. While writing programs, the statement should be intended properly so that the reader can easily determine the structure of program. It means that whenever you are writing the program, it should be good, means like in a good way it should be written, that easily you can find out and we can understand. Like here is the some program, it's a curly braces are on the like state on the proper position, it is that we can understand it. Okay, so like it you have to write it nicely. Next program, one more program based on the if statement. Write a program to check whether enter number is positive or negative. That number is positive or negative means that number is plus number or minus number, positive or negative. So first of all there is a class name we have declared, public class positive. Then started the curly braces public, then we have one function, this is the main function we have declared, and here we have passed that integer number. We have declared this is the one variable num, this is integer type, which type of integer. Okay, now variable num is declared here. Now next, system dot print out enter number is whatever, once your program will be executed, your bytecode will run. Actually in the Java bytecode is running, so that bytecode will run, at that time you it will be asked enter the number, the cursor will be blink, and you will enter the number, whatever the number you will enter, simply it will come to here and it will display here enter number is 67, because it is here plus in the place of n num, it will be display 67, because num we have declared here, integer type. Now next, देन आफ्टर दिस कंडीशन विल बी चेक्ड. नाउ दिस कंडीशन इफ नम इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो मीन्स वट एवर द नंबर यू हैव एंटर इज इट ग्रेटर देन जीरो. इफ यस देन इट विल कम टू हियर सिस्टम डॉट प्रिंट आउट नंबर इज पॉजिटिव. गॉट इट. नंबर इज पॉजिटिव बिकॉज वी नो दैट इन द नंबर लाइन यू नो दैट दिस इज द जीरो. इफ यू विल मूव टू द राइट साइड वी विल गेट द पॉजिटिव नंबर्स. ओके वी विल गेट द पॉजिटिव नंबर्स. इफ यू मूव टू द लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ दिस नंबर लाइन लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द जीरो ऑल द डिजिट वट एवर यू विल गेट दैट विल बी द माइनस नंबर. सो दैट्स वाई इट इज गिवन दिस लॉजिक नंबर ग्रेटर देन जीरो मीन्स नंबर विल बी ग्रेटर देन जीरो दैट विल बी द पॉजिटिव. If it is less than 0, it means the number will be negative. So it is true here, if number is greater than 0, so it will be displayed number is a positive number. So this is your output. If it is not, then after, so it will actually they have not given that condition, only the condition is written then, if the condition evaluates true. So here is the only condition to you can add this one more statement like this. System, this is the negative. For this you can write system dot out print out and here you can write negative number. So here you can add this, here is that you can add one more statement. Here is system dot print out dot ln and here you can write number is negative. So one more statement you can execute, then after it will come to the here. If it is a false it will come here. Okay, but that is not mentioned here, so you can modify it. Now next you can see there is some facts. If there is more than one statement to be executed in the true or false parts of if statement, then this statement should be in closed curly braces. Okay, so more than one it means like if it is not true then it will come, so that must be closed under this enclosed with the curly braces. A sequence of statement enclosed within a pair of braces are called compound statement. So they are called the so many there is statements that is enclosed under this between this curly braces. So they are called the compound statements. Now if statements we have learned, now we will see, we will discuss the new one, which is next part, which is the if else. Now we will learn about the if else, how we will use this one, what is the use of if else. So in this, if else is a logical situation where either of two actions are to be performed. Two actions here is simple that in example simple just to just see that if you will get the like movie ticket, if you will get the movie ticket we will watch the movie, otherwise nothing we will do, we will be at the home. If two statement like two, if we will get the movie ticket so we will watch the movie, otherwise if we not get the movie this movie ticket we will eat somewhere in the restaurant. So there are two conditions like if we get the ticket then we will watch the movie, if we not get the ticket we will eat the restaurant. So this is your if else. Okay, this is your if else. Okay, and here in this case you can see if we will get the movie ticket we will watch the movie, otherwise nothing means we will be remain there. So this is your if statement. Okay, now in the condition evaluates true, then the statements written inside the body of if block and that will be executed. Otherwise statement else block will get executed, means there will be the another block of the else and there will be the block of if, means there will be two blocks for that particular, for the if will be there some block and for the else will be there block. Okay, if else block will be there. So means if it is a true, so means like if we will get the ticket so we will watch the movie, if we will not get the ticket we will come here, we will go to the restaurant and we will eat there. So there will be the two different blocks. So let's see the one by one. So first of all it's a syntax you will see. What is the syntax? The general syntax of if else it is if there is the expression will be there, some mathematical operators will be there, boolean expression. If it is true it will execute this state, this block, Java block. So these blocks of statement gets executed if condition boolean expression is true. Okay, If it is not true, means this block will executed when the condition boolean expression is false. When it is a false, then it will be executed. And when it is a true, it will execute here. If it is a false, means if we'll get the movie ticket, we will watch the movie. If we'll not get the movie ticket, we will go to the restaurant and we will eat. So there is, you can see clearly, here is the else block and this is the if block. This is the block for the, you can, this is the whole block for the if and this is for the else. So here you can understand in the flow chart also. In this flow chart you can see, if here will be text expression, means this will be tested here. Okay, this is a text expression. If it is a true, body of if means this particular portion will be run. If it is a false, body of else, this particular portion will be run. Okay, then after you can see it here, some examples, some programs. Write a program to find the largest of two numbers. There are two numbers will be there, and between that, among them, which one is the greatest number, that one you have to find out. So how to write the program for this? So first of all, class largest, one class we have declared, its name is largest. Then after one function, main function, like a public static void main, and there we have passed a string argument, that will be the which type of arguments, which is the string. So now here we have declared, you can declare it here also, but here now in this case, you know, already I taught about how to declare your variables. Now here you can see, here we have declared integer a and its a value we have given 5 and 7. You can declare it also here, but that is another method. So here we are declaring in the inside the main function. Okay, so here is that integer a, which is the like integer a, and its a value is 5, and which is integer b, and that's the value is 7. Okay, and this comma and semicolon, how to declare, so everything you have to take keep in your mind. And one more thing I want to tell you, this same type of concept you can use in C++, C, and here also. Okay, means like mostly it is similar. Now here you can see, if, now here is the condition is there, if a is greater than b, means is a's value is 5, b's value is 7. So it is talking about this one, 5 is greater than 7, is it? No. So this is the false statement. So it means it will come to here, if it will come to the here, because false. So system number b is the greatest number, because this is for the b and this is for the a. So what it will say, b is the greatest number. Suppose if we have written, in the case of a we have declared 5, we have declared the 5, and b we have declared the 2. In that case, what it will happen, 5 greater than 2. In this case, this will be the true condition. So in this case, it will come to the here. Okay, this is the for the true case and this is for the false case. So that's why it come to the else, because as I told that when it is a false, it will come to the which block? Else block. If it is a true, it will come to the if block. This is the if block and this one is your else block. Okay, so whenever it will be false, it will come to the else block. Okay, so now here it is a false, because this is the false one, so it will come to the here, and this one will be printed, it will be displayed, b is the largest number. Next program, write a program to find whether enter number is even or odd. So that we will check that whether this number is even or odd. So how? First of all, we will declare one class. Class name is we have given even odd. So first of all, main function, and here we have passed integer type num. We have declared that is a num, one of the variable, and which is which kind of variable? It is integer. Now variable name here is declared. Now system dot print out, so whatever the number that will be, you will enter, so that will be displayed. So that, suppose here they have entered 54 maybe, so that is displaying here 54. Okay, now here is condition is there, if number divided by 2 equals to 0. Do you know what is the difference between this one and this one? Whenever you will use this one, so it gives the what? It will give your remainder. It will give the exactly remainder, and this is give only the quotient. it will give the quotient. Means when you will divide by number 2 and it is greater than, means exactly it will divide. This is remainder will be there. Remainder means like remainder will be 0. What is for the even and odd? Even number, when you divide by 2, it will exactly, it will divide, means remainder will be 0. Exactly divide means what? Remainder will be 0. Okay. So that concept we are using here. So if you divide that number by 2 and that equals to 0, means its remainder will be 0, means that will be exactly divided. So if it will be exactly divided by 2, it means that number is even number. So if it is a true, so that will display system dot order even number is even. If it is a true. Suppose if it is not a true, then it will execute this one else statement. So what is the else block? System number is odd number. So when it is possible, suppose you have entered 37. So in that case, you will divide by 2, and we are asking about it is this one 37. So whenever you will divide, in this case, you will not get the remainder will be 0. In this case, your remainder will be something different. You will divide by 32. So 2 1 are 2. So here will be 1 17. So 2 8 are 16. So you will get there will be the remainder 1. So remainder will be 1. So here is a value will come to the 1 and it is equals to 0. No, it is not equal to 0. It means it will be false, and so that's why it will come to here and it will display system.print.ln number is, or means that number will be this here will come number is odd. Okay, now so this is the use of if and else. Okay, now next use we will see the next part, which is if else if, means two times if else if. If it is true, then do, otherwise this one, otherwise this one, means we have given condition like this, like we will get the if we get the ticket, movie ticket, if we will get the ticket, so we will watch the movie, otherwise we will go to the restaurant. Okay, if restaurant is closed, okay, so then we will go to the park. Okay, so there are three conditions we are giving. If we will get the ticket, we will watch the movie. The first priority we have to watch the movie. This is the first priority. If we will not get the ticket, the second priority, we will go to the restaurant. If this one is also not there, our third priority is to go to the park. So this is the final one, means nothing we will, these two, if it is not true, then we will go to the here. Okay, so likewise in this condition, if this if statement will true, so it will execute here. Otherwise we will write like this, else if. Okay, else if, in this case second statement will be second statement will be executed, otherwise simple else. Okay, so three conditions we are giving. So in this case we will use this one, if else. Okay, so if else if ladder is an extension of if else condition branching statements. Okay, branching means there are more than more conditions. It is used when we have to check multiple conditions before taking a decision. If else if ladder provides a proper skeleton to check multiple condition whenever every condition has a block of a statement within itself. Okay, so let's see. First of all is the syntax. Syntax is same syntax. Like first of all is the, we will check this expression. If it is a true, so this is the if block. If it is a true, first priority is there, so this block will get executed if the condition is true. First one means first priority. This block will be then next. If it is not true, then it will come to the here. If else if, this block statement get executed if statement written else if is true, means second one is true. So here will be the also there is the condition will be there. In this also you will get the condition. As I told that if we get the movie ticket, we will watch the movie. That's our first priority. If that priority is not, then second priority, what condition we have given? Second, then we will go to the restaurant. If restaurant is closed, then we will go to the park. So here is the second priority is there. If it is a true, then it will execute. If it is a false, it will come to here and its condition will be checked. What is the condition there? If suppose this condition is true, then it will execute. Otherwise, if this condition is also not true, then it will come to the here final one that we are told that go to the for the second. Okay, so here is written Boolean expression. Here is again it will be there. So this block gets executed if all above condition of Boolean is written false, then it will be there. Again, you can use more if else you can use. Okay, so many conditions in between that you can use. That is up to you. Okay. Now here is it's a flow chart. You can see start test the condition. If it is a false, it will go to the second condition, and if it is again it is a false, it will go to the else body and it will stop. If it first condition is true, it will execute. If second condition is true, it will execute and end. So likewise, if nothing will be there, if this is not true, this is not true, exactly it will come here and out. Okay. Now here is some programs we will see about this one. If condition written inside here you can see if the condition written inside if block is true, the statement associated with that if get executed and the rest of ladder bypassed. Means that if first one is true, then no need to check for the rest. If none of condition is true, the final else will be executed. Means between that, like here, this is not true, this is not true, then automatically it will come to the final one. That is here is it is telling final statement will be executed. The final else act as default condition. That is the default condition. Means nothing is true, means like we will get the ticket. So nothing will true, means like no, we will not get the movie ticket, we will not get the restaurant. So default we will go to the park. So means nothing we will have, means one plan is fixed that must I will do. So that is like here is that is the default one. If all other condition test fail, then the last else statement will be performed, and if there is no final else, then all other conditions are false, no action will be taken place. So if you have not declared that one last one also, so nothing will be there, no any action will be take place. Okay, so here is all other actions are false, then no action will be take place. Okay, here is somewhere, here is the program. Create a program that will display message, one message that will be displayed. First message, hi, the value equals to 1. Second, hello, if value is 2. No match, none of the condition is matching. So how to write this? So first of all, we will declare the class name is if else if ladder, the name of the class we have given. Now here is that this is a main function, and we pass the value, integer type of value, and first of all that value will be asked to enter. So that will be displayed, enter value plus, means this is the as you know that under this inverted comma, this two means it, that same thing will be displayed, and with the this is the joint one value, whatever the value that will be come with this here, so that will be displayed there. Now first condition we have given, so now we have used the condition if. So this block executed when value equals to 1. So here is the value equals to 1. If whatever the value we have entered here, this value, if this value equals to 1, then it will execute here. If it is not true, so then it will come to the here. If value is 2, it will check that. It will check again. Value is either it is 2. This block will executed if value is the 2. Now, if it is not true, if it is not true, it will come to here. And it will check here value is 2. Yes, if it is 2, then it will execute. Otherwise, it will again send to the here else, whatever here that you just display. So here in this case, what is the given value? Suppose I have entered 2. So if I have entered 2, first of all, it will come this 2, means this value will be 2. So enter value will display there is 2. So that will come to here and it will check. It is false, so it will not execute and it will come to the here. So now it will check value equals to 2. Yes, so the system dot print out value. So that will display the hello. Whatever that the message will come, hello. Otherwise, if that value is not equal, it will simply go to the here and no match found. So this is the flow chart. Means as I told that chapter 4 I taught, whenever you are writing any program, first of all we are writing the algorithm, and the from algorithm to we are writing the flow chart. So that is the here is the, for any writing program, first of all we have to write the flow chart, because that give you the idea how to write the your code, how to separate the codes, how to divide the codes, so you can do. So this is very important. If you have to write the any program and you are nothing you are getting, first of all you have to try to write it's the flowchart. So in this start, read the value, means that value, whatever the value you have given, so that will be checked here. If it is equals to 1, so that will print high. If it is no, because this type of box is called diamond box and this is the decision box, no, then after here again it will ask equals to 2, then after you go to this side and print the hello. If it is no, then you just write it. So based on this flow chart, you can write this program. So very important to write this flow chart. Okay.